just woke up.
Yeah, why don't you mind me?
That is very true.
Why you take my papers? Morning, everybody. We are the Breakfast Club. We got our guest co-hosts, Carrie Champion and Lauren LaRosa with us. And let's get to the rumors.
Lauren LaRosa.
So I've been here for a little bit.
Recognize the voice and the name.
Here we go.
On the Breakfast Club. Lauren came in hot.
You know, well, I came in telling the truth.
Guys, Nicki Minaj dropped today. I know we heard a song this morning off the album, mm-hmm. Pink Friday 2. So this is her first album since 2018 when she dropped Queen. And people are really excited. So there is a lot that is, a lot of songs that are picking up. People are really in love with Falling For You, At The Club, Big Difference. But there is a song on the album that J. Cole is featured on, and it has people going back and forth on Twitter about what are J. Cole's best features, because he bodied this feature. Let's take a listen.
You like a lover, like a brother, like a manager, A&R, plus a therapist when it start raining hard. Her life was trauma filled, it left her with a tainted heart. Yeah, you didn't know that she wanted to tell her name across. But you need patience and a lot of extra faith in God to keep the family together at a time when it's so regular to break apart. So God forbid, y'all got a kid, therefore I hate the thought. It's you and her against the world until it ain't no more. Breath in your lungs, I'm just a messenger.
So on this song, Nicki Minaj is talking about, like, just some issues that it seems like her and her husband were having, mm-hmm. which is a first. I've never heard her talk about their relationship in this way. But she basically says that they go through things, and, like, sometimes she be needing a time away from him. And J. Cole is talking to him about how to be a man supporting a woman that is a Nicki Minaj. You guys just had a kid. It's very public. Nicki, we have a verse from Nicki, right? No. Okay, so how y'all feeling about the feature? People are arguing that this is one of his best.
It's interesting that people say this is the first time they heard Nicki talk about it. It's the first time Nicki dropped an album since she's been married.
No, but she's been married for some time publicly.
She got married in 2019.
Yeah, but
she
that's...
She put out albums in 2018.
That's a lot of time. But she's put out music. That's a lot
not
of time.
Not an album, though. Most of the time people address things like that in their album.
But it's a lot of time for some music to be out and for... She talks about her marriage very often, and we've never heard her... I've never heard her talk openly about kind of going through things. I'm going to figure out being married publicly with a new baby.
I mean, the feature was all right. It was cool. A cool feature.
I got to hear the whole song. Hopefully we can play the whole song after the rumors so that we can listen to it. Yeah, but, you know, Nicki does live a lot, but she doesn't really talk about her family. I mean, she just recently talked about the name of her son, right? Did she even mention that?
I don't think she has.
She hasn't given a name. She's very private when it comes to her family in that way. So this is something new that Nicki's doing.
I like Needle. Needle is dope with Drake. I like Cowgirl. I like Everybody. I like Big Difference. Those are the records that are standing out to me upon first listen.
Mm-hmm. Upon first listening. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I heard it.
I haven't heard the whole album, but those records are dope. Mm-hmm.
I just like to see Nicki be able to just be a little bit soft. Like, that. This was one of the things that caught me. And then another thing that happened, too, on Twitter, and it's still happening right now. So Pink Friday 2, of course, is trending. All of the songs from the different records are trending. Mm-hmm. And then the fans are doing this whole thing where now We Want Cardi is trending number 2 under Nicki's Pink Friday 2 trending at number 1. And it's like, why do that? Why can't we enjoy Nicki today?
That's Cardi fans and the balls.
I hate that. I love the powerhouses that these two women are, and I would love to just enjoy Nicki today. It's her birthday. Let that girl rock today.
You know what? I hate that, you know, this album didn't have a bigger rollout. Like, I'm mad that the album just dropped. Like, we knew it was coming out, but it's Nicki Minaj. Like, I don't even know who she signed to. Universal still?
I'm not sure.
I don't know who she signed to, but whoever she signed to, it's just like, yo, Nicki needed and deserved a bigger rollout.
What did you want? What would it look like?
A record? Like, she got records on this album. Like, why wouldn't a single come out? You know what I mean? Like, why wouldn't a big video come out before the album?
Do you feel like the Wayne album and pushing the dates and all that stepped on it?
I don't think so. Wayne album didn't come.
It did. Remember she had to move it because Wayne had a project that dropped.
I don't think that has nothing to do with it. I'm just saying, like, the label in general should have had a bigger plan for a Nicki Minaj album.
Yeah,
I am sick of big artists dropping and there's no rollout.
Yo, you know, like, the sad thing is when I seen it, I thought it was a surprise album because I forgot she was dropping.
No.
I remember she mentioned it.
Because she mentioned it a couple of weeks ago, like you said, and she said, you know, she's gonna change the date because Wayne and
yes.
Labels. And what's the name's album?
It's because we're used to her doing like when Queen dropped, it was Queen Radio. Yeah. It was she literally stopped the world.
Everything.
Like the city stopped.
Yeah.
The world stopped.
Labels gotta stop relying on artists and their social media followings to get the word out. Labels gotta do their job. What's the point of being signed to a label if labels aren't gonna, you know, provide those kind of resources to give you the big rollouts that you deserve? It's Nicki Minaj. Mm-hmm.
Nicki Minaj.
They tried a little bit. I know she had the, I think it was the Vogue cover. She did a cover of Magazine. I really think it was Vogue, but it was like bits and pieces. It wasn't like the uniform thing that we normally see. But I don't think rollout plans are as good as they used to be. anymore. Like, it just doesn't happen anymore.
I think a lot of times with artists, yeah, labels ain't doing their job, and sometimes artists just don't want to do it. You know what I mean? So it's like, even when you look at Busta Rhymes, that he just released that project 2 weeks ago, right? And Busta tried to do, Busta did everything. Busta did all the radio shows. He did the radio. He did the record stores. He did the performances. You know, we got to get back to that so people understand what's coming out, and then we got to love the music.
And so Sim just pointed out that she did have, so she did like a futuristic thing where she had like the whole AI world. It's called Gag City. Mm-hmm. And that was a rollout. It was an AI universe. But I think AI and those universes and all that stuff is kind of, it goes over the average listener's head.
Yeah.
But I did, like, I found that out today when I was just looking at what was online. And then I do have a lot of friends on the media side. Like, I have some paps that are hitting me up right now that are telling me that a lot of people are telling like paparazzi, a lot of her events, her party, just press things that she was supposed to do today were canceled. So I don't know what's happening, but it was put out there to paps that were looking for her to be out and about at these places that these things were canceled and they weren't happening anymore. So all I don't know, maybe we don't know, but
she definitely got some big records on this album.
She does,
like I said, Needle with Drake, Cowgirl. I think Uzi on Cowgirl.
No,
it's everybody that Uzi's on.
Everybody's hard,
everybody's dope.
Big difference. She got some big records on it.
Well, yeah, I'm excited to get back in the car. It's like 22 songs and listen to it.
But let's get into a joint right now. That is your rumor report. Let's get into a joint right now. Let's get into the joint featuring J. Cole. We got that full version. It's called Let Me Calm Down. All right? It's the Breakfast Club. Good morning.